Good morning, everybody. First of all, I would like to thank the Swiss Cooperation Agency for all the support they have given to us. From 2006, we have had the support, and we have been able to develop a successful pilot program in Transantiago, which ended up with a new emission policy and regulation, which have now led us to have 3,000 buses with the DPFs installed. And I would like to thank also the presence of other cities in Latin America. And also for us, it's an honor to be able to introduce the first progresses we have had in the regulation of mobile sources. Oh, well, thank you very much. We will start now. My presentation is basically focused on air quality background, then presenting you results of the evolution in quality of air for the different measures in these years, and then presenting you what's next, what will be coming, what we have next. And the Secretary mentioned something, but I will focus on the measures with emission data, projections of emissions, so that you have an idea of what is coming next. Background. Well, just to start understanding the problem we have in the metropolitan region, for those who don't know the problem, many of you know it, but in the metropolitan region, we have serious contamination problems during the winter. Basically, because of the geographic conditions we are in, we are surrounded by hills, and also because of the meteorologic conditions that affect contamination in winter, especially between April and August. So as I mentioned, we have a geographic restriction. We are surrounded by hills. And the other problem is a thermal inversion layer that is causing us trouble every year. Even when emissions within the city are not as high as other cities with the same amount of number of inhabitants, because of the thermal inversion layer, the accumulation and concentration of contaminants in winter becomes really critical in terms of their levels. It's what the meteorologic conditions were so critical that we have very high levels of contamination last year. So in winter, we need to take more demanding measures. Apart from all the structural measures, we need to have specific measurements for those specific episodes of critical contamination levels. In this slide, you have quite a lot of information, but it shows the evolution of the reduction of PM, fine PM. We see that during the 90s we had concentrations of about 70 micrograms, and now we are in 27. We have had a considerable reduction in the annual reduction of PM because of an amount of measures that we have established, especially regarding the transport. We can outline and highlight the 92 regulations of the 92 regulation that implemented the prohibition of used vehicles and forced the entry into the market of catalytic vehicles. And this implied a reduction of PM. And this was one of the key measures that was established in 92. Another key measure was the improvement in the quality of fields because of the investment of ENAP, the National Petroleum Company, to reduce the contaminant in their field. And also the quality of diesel improved their levels of sulfur. This allowed us to have a pilot start the pilot program with Transantiago. We had cooperation from the Swiss Cooperation Agency as well. And because of this program, we were able to implement an entry regulation that imply that all the Transantiago buses that entered the system had to have the DPF. So we were able to implement a stricter measure for that. Another important measure in terms of the control of current vehicles, was a higher level of requirements of technical plants, so that we could have a better control on old catalytic vehicles. And we started with rather soft standards, and now we have more demanding standards. Now, in 2010, we started with the incorporation of 3,000 buses with the DPF because of the renewal of the fleet during the time. And another important measure was the improvement of the quality of the diesel fuel, reducing from 50 to 15 ppm particulates per meter. And this was very important for implementing the Euro 5 regulation for light and heavy vehicles, diesel vehicles, light and heavy. This is from 2013. And I would like to highlight those measures that have been established in transport to have such improvements in the quality of the fuel we have. Here's some background on air quality. These are our regulations which are currently in valid, the daily and the annual levels of PMs. As you see at the bottom, in the chart at the bottom, we had different levels in the episodes of critical contamination levels. Depending on the microgram levels, we define whether it's alert, pre-emergency, or emergency. So as you can see, in pre-emergency levels are going quite beyond in several micrograms what is the current daily level. So we need to have more strict, stringent measures for the daily values. And these are the levels which are the concentrations of PM, so you can have an idea of what are the levels that we reach in the winter. These are the stations that are currently in the metropolitan region. This is a map of the region. And in the city, we have several stations that record the concentrations of PM and gases. In this graphic, we can see the evolution of all the contamination episodes during this period of PM10. And we see a reduction of the number of episodes of critical PM levels during these years. And last year, we had 12 alerts and 3 PM emergencies in PMT. And regarding 2.5, it's been more variable. We have experienced a gradual reduction, but last year we have a very critical condition because of the weather. We had really low ventilation levels last year, so we had 33 and 15 pre-emergency, and 3 emergency was quite a critical winter last year. And well, because of this, we are thinking of establishing new measures to reduce even further the reduction levels of the different sources. Well, next I will be presenting the new measures that will be established in the new decontamination plan. We are reformulating the plan currently, and we intend to publish the like at the end of the year, probably. We will have a draft project for the end of the year. And I will talk about the measures associated to diesel emissions control. We have the emissions inventory here. You can see that transport and machinery have an important contribution in the direct PM, 15%. Machinery, and in terms of gases, is quite high, especially in NOx. So we have a very important contribution of these sources for the for as direct contamination as a precursor of PM. Coming into the measures that are being considered are to establish a low emission zone for cargo transport, special regulations for the entry of trucks into the specific city ring, permanent restriction for catalytic converted vehicles, but regarding the years of the vehicle. Another measurement is with machineries. It's a segment that has a very high impact equivalent. And we have the idea of focusing our efforts in this sector. And we want to make a requirement of retrofit levels for special project of the state, of the government. And also we want to define in the new plan is the Euro 6 regulation for Transantiago buses. And also we have to review all the entry regulations for cars which are sold in the country. The idea is to have a national regulation on this. These are the levels that will be required for Transantiago, and we see that the measures intend to establish Euro 6 technology from September 2017. So before we renew the fleet and the new bidding of the Transantiago system, we can establish such regulations. Here we have the emissions projection is based on the renewal of the fleet from here, 2023, where we intend to renew 4,600 vehicles. So that's the analysis we are doing, and we see that because of this scenario, we have the PM emissions. The baseline is here. This is the baseline. This is if the new fleet would be renewed by Euro 5, and the blue line is with Euro 6. So the reduction, as you can see, is significant in terms of PM and NOx. Also, the red line up there is baseline, and the blue line down is Euro 6. Sorry, Euro 6 reduces nitrous oxides of approximately 80% higher than Euro 5. So Euro 6 is a different technology. And with this, we have to reduce Transantiago emissions quite considerably. It's a sector that also already has lower emissions, but with this technology, the emissions will be really low. In this graph, you can see, in this chart, you can see the low emission levels. We want to establish regulation for the low emission areas, establishing a limit for age in vehicles, which is 12 years. And we did projections of the emissions evaluating this option of the age of the vehicles, and we have the fleets of trucks 2018. As you can see, this is like as the park is composed and the projection we do, and we see that the fleet has experienced an important renewal. For 2018, we wouldn't have older regulation, no Euro or Euro 1, and we will have only, 12,000 trucks Euro 2 that will be affected to the 12-year measure. So if you project this in 12 years, from 2018 we will have this fleet affected by this. So if we make the projection, we see that the blue line, in this case, is the baseline, which is a natural renewal of the fleet nowadays, and the green line corresponds to the situation where we apply the 12-year regulation. So we see that there will be a speeding up of the renewal for the fleet because of this regulation. So we will have a very interesting effect of the regulation in this area. And also, if we take this, if we analyze this regarding technology, we will have for 2018 only the Euro 3 trucks will be allowed to enter the fleet, and for 2022 only Euro 4 technologies will be permitted. So regulation is quite strong and has a very important impact. And the last one, the last slide. I didn't mention the rest of measurements and restrictions because it's not what we are dealing with here, but we have still some other measures as vehicular restrictions. Sorry, we still have machinery. Regarding machinery, we have description of emissions and the fleet, and we see the machinery building in the building area has the highest participation in the region. This is agricultural, this is different industry and mining. In the region, the one that has a higher impact is building machinery. And at the side, you can see the contributions by the level of power. And what you see in the next chart is the number of machinery in the region. So what the plans intend is to establish specific regulation for the building area, because they are the one that implies the higher impacts in contamination of the city. And the idea is to establish demands, requirements of DPF use for the projects that are tendered by the Ministry of Public Works. For those who want to apply for such tenders, they need to have a certain level of requirements for DPF. And we will establish stage 3, and then we will establish the regulation corresponding to stage 3B or 4. And we have the reduction here. Baseline starting 800 tons, which is quite a lot. If we don't do anything, we have this projected level of emissions. It will go higher. It will increase. With the regulation, we will have this. And with retrofit, we will have these regulations at 2025. So the measurements are quite cost effective, and we want to go towards the regulation of this sector in the new plan. And now this was the last one, actually. Thank you very much for your attention.